One of Yunling's best moves are his fire arrows. With their long range and being very fast, opponents get hit by them often. Using arrows for chip damage is good, but you can also combo and kill confirm opponents from the other side of the stage. This video will show you the different arrow combos you can perform, along with multiple ways to input arrow ladders. Before we get started, I recommend having one of your shoulder buttons set as jump, along with easy accessibility to a second jump button with your pointer finger. For one of the methods, you will need to press two jump buttons at the same time while inputting a special. I use X to jump and smash, but I find it difficult to claw an X with my pointer finger, so I have Y also set to jump to combat this issue. In Ultimate, you can buffer full hop and short hop specials. To buffer full hop specials, press jump and special at the same time. To buffer short hop specials, you have two options. You can either press two jump buttons and special at the same time, or you can press one jump button and special, then very slightly afterwards, press grab. If you mistime the grab method, you will get a Zare instead of a special, which is why I prefer the two jump buttons method. But whichever method you choose will work. You can also decide not to use any macro, but the percent windows will be much tighter, so I recommend using a macro. When landing an arrow further away from the opponent, you can chain multiple arrows together into a finisher to get a combo, or even to take a stock. There are two main variations of arrow ladders. From 90 to 120%, you can do arrow to short hop arrow to full hop arrow to aerial. And from 140 to 170%, you can do arrow to full hop arrow to aerial. You can also finish the arrow ladders with aerial spin attack, but it can be inconsistent and may kill later than doing a fair or a down air. To input the first ladder using the special macros, you need to first land an arrow, then flick the control stick forwards and press the shoulder button jump, your second button jump, and special at the same time. Then touch the ground briefly and buffer a full hop special. Then use your double jump with whichever aerial fits the situation best. Dare will be your strongest killing option anywhere on stage, but if you are close to the side blast zones, then fair will be your best option. Depending on the opponent's DI and the character's hurtbox shifting, you may need to use up air to finish the combo. One important note is the second arrow will not be true on any character with a frame 3 air dodge or faster, but even if the second arrow isn't true, it will still hit 99% of the time, since it is hard for the opponent to react to and escape frame perfectly. Every move after the second arrow will be true though. The second arrow ladder is much easier to input. You first need to land an arrow, then flick the control stick forwards while pressing shoulder button jump and special at the same time. Then use whichever aerial fits the situation best. Percentage windows will change slightly with the character's weight, her box shifting, and rage. Lighter weight characters will have lower percent windows. For example, Fox will be arrow laddered from 80 to 100% with short hop arrow, and 130 to 160% for full hop arrow. Rage will generally decrease percent windows by 10 to 20%. At max rage, you will even be able to start arrow ladders on Fox at 60%. Charging the initial arrow slightly will also lower percent windows. Characters with bigger hurtboxes will also be easier to arrow ladder. One problem you may have depending on your controller is snapback. If that is the case on your controller, you can try to rely less on flicking your stick forwards. Instead, you will have to guide the stick back to its initial position quickly with your thumb. Another option is to replace the control stick or replace the controller entirely, but both of those options can be expensive and time-consuming. If you want to learn more about snapback, there is a video in the description that goes over it. For some more basic arrow combos, at mid-range, arrow to nair is true from 30 to 170%. Another basic combo at close range is arrow to up air from 90 to 200%. For both of these combos, it is important to flick your control stick forwards slightly before the aerial. A flashy kill confirm you can go for is wall jump to be reverse arrow to dare. This combo is a good mix-up to use when at ledge, but it shouldn't be used too much or else it will become predictable. An application of fire arrows that is useful on platform stages is tech chasing with an arrow. When the opponent is under a platform, you can hit them with an arrow and punish their tech option on the platform above them. Depending on the platform heights, the percentage windows change slightly, but to give a basis, on Battlefield and Small Battlefield, this works from 80 to 100%, and on PS2, from 100 to 120%. If they miss the tech, you can kill them with a strong dare. If they tech it though, you can try to react or read it to get a punish. Using full hop buffered arrows when the opponent is on a platform can also give you a solid conversion to a combo or kill confirm. Yuan Ling's fire arrows are quite a free flowing tool he can use in his neutral and advantage state, which is why it's important to use them to the maximum. Just using them as a spam tool isn't using them to their full potential. Kill confirming people from the other side of the stage is quite fun, at least as the one shooting the arrows. If you have any video ideas I could do on Yuan Ling or any Hollow Knight content, it would be greatly appreciated if you could comment those down below. But with that, thank you for watching this video.